On this week's episode of What's Up Weekly, we get prepped for Thanksgiving next week by talking with students about their plans.
And Hank Ruff and the Hellbenders are in studio for a special live performance. What's Up Weekly starts now.
Hello and welcome to this week's episode of What's Up Weekly. I'm Anna Black.
And I'm Callie Lichter.
This weekend, the School of Public Health displayed sections of a 54-ton piece of artwork. After 5 years, the AIDS Memorial quilt made its way back to Bloomington. The quilt acts as a living memorial, each panel or patch representing someone who's died from AIDS. The entire piece contains 50,000 panels and over 110,000 names. But only 240 panels were on display here. People read the names on panels aloud while visitors took an emotional walk through history. The quilt's history dates back to 1985 when human rights activist Cleve Jones honored over 1,000 AIDS victims in San Francisco. Coordinators for the exhibit say they brought it back after learning about students' lack of awareness on AIDS, its history, and its global impact.
You know, the younger generation, they don't necessarily realize the early days of the epidemic and the amount of, you know, pain and death and also activism that came out of that. And so we really need to honor and respect the lives that were lost as a result of this disease and also government inaction.
Those involved with the exhibit say they hope it helps personalize the disease, reduces stigma, and encourages more education and preventative action. In addition to the quill, other AIDS-related events included free HIV testing, panel discussions, musical performances, and a drag show.
Thanksgiving is quickly approaching, and Hoosiers are getting ready for the holidays. What's Up Weekly reporter Brooklyn Lambright caught up with students this week to ask about their Thanksgiving plans. Brooklyn?
Thanks, guys. I'm here outside Sample Gates with Stephanie and Ben, and we're going to talk about their Thanksgiving break. So what do you guys have coming up?
I'm flying to Florida on the 18th to visit my dad and my family that lives down there. We're going to Universal Studios, and then for the last half of the week, I'll be back up here with my mom.
Very nice.
And then I will just be going back up to Indianapolis, visit some family there, and then probably have some dinner or something like that, just how Thanksgiving goes every year.
I'm
going
to see family, probably, and hang out with my mom and go shopping.
Yep, same thing for me. I'm going home, hanging out with my mom and dog.
Oh, the dog.
Setting up for Christmas is our main thing.
I'm going home to New Jersey and then driving back up to Massachusetts to see my family.
I'm going home to Wisconsin, going to Thanksgiving with my family.
I'll probably be going home and might be doing a little traveling to see family and just enjoying the time off.
Very nice.
I'm going to be running a turkey trot with my family and then eating lots of good food.
What do you guys have planned for Thanksgiving break?
I'm going to Nashville, Tennessee. I'm going to hang out with some family. Yeah.
Born in Chicago.
Very cool. What's in Chicago?
My family.
Okay.
So my Thanksgiving break, I'm planning on going home and seeing my family. I haven't been home since I actually got here for the year, since I'm a freshman. But, you know, I'm really excited. Excited for some Thanksgiving food and all that kind of stuff. And so excited to see family and extended family. I've had a couple of years of COVID and stuff, so I'm kind of excited for a normal Thanksgiving. And it's going to be fun.
Awesome. Thanks so much.
Thanks, Brooklyn. We are starting this week's Trending Topics with an actress from hit series Friends who just got personal about her pregnancy troubles.
Jennifer Aniston revealed to Allure magazine that she struggled with infertility during her 30s and 40s. Aniston says it was a hard point in her life, but shaped her into who she is now. The 53-year-old actress says she attempted many different methods, including in vitro fertilization. The one thing Aniston says she wished she knew: to freeze her eggs. Despite everything, she says she's not regretful and is at peace with the situation.
Speaking of Jennifer, we would be remiss if we didn't mention the death of her dad. The Days of Our Lives actor John Aniston passed away Monday morning at the age of 89.
The Office actor Rainn Wilson changed his name over the weekend to raise awareness about climate change.
The actor debuted his new name as a cheap little stunt to help save planet Earth. His new name, Rainfall Heat Wave Rising Sea Levels Wilson. Even though the name change was unofficial and had many variations, he said that the move was to let world leaders know that climate change is ruining the Arctic and our planet.
He encouraged other celebrities to change their names as well. Some of my favorites include Cardi, the Arctic be melting, Samuel, Earth is getting hot as L. Jackson and Amy, polar bears are endangered.
And the queen of country just received a huge paycheck, but this time it's not for her music.
Singer Dolly Parton just received Jeff Bezos' $100 million Courage and Civility Award. The country star is known for her classic bops, but also her philanthropic work. She gave Vanderbilt University's Medical Center $1 million for vaccine research during the height of the coronavirus, money which aided the Moderna vaccine. Bezos, the founder and face of Amazon, says Dolly and other recipients have free range with the funds. In 2021, he said they can give this money to their own foundations or allocate it to other areas of need.
You know, Anna, it's really nice to see stars and corporate gurus use their money to help others, and especially when it's a large chunk of change like this.
Oh, yeah. Well, don't go anywhere. On the other side of the break, Hank Ruff and the Hellbenders will be performing live in studio.
We'll be right back.
Play another song here. My dad wrote this song about 30 years ago. It's called I'm Not Crazy, But I'm Out of Her Mind. Lately, if you've seen me out of all the barrooms with any woman every night. Your opinion of me is probably on its way down. Let me give you a little insight. There is a reason I'm acting this way. In case you were wondering why, I may seem happy, crazy, but I'm trying not to betray the heartache I'm feeling inside. So if you see me and you think I'm going crazy, if you think that I'm acting like a fool, drinking and yelling one minute, then sitting silent for hours on some bar stool. Well, don't just write me off as some loser. Look in my eyes and you'll find a broken-hearted man. Maybe then you'll understand. I'm not crazy, but I'm out of her mind. Things lately have been a whole lot harder for me to face. I'll be getting myself back together again, but right now I'm something of a disgrace. With the way that I'm coping, you may disagree. Maybe you just don't understand. I'm not looking for attention or for sympathy. I'm just doing the best that I can. So if you see me and you think I've gone crazy, if you think that I'm acting like a fool, drinking and yelling one minute, then sitting silent for hours on some bar stool. But don't just write me off as some loser. Look in my eyes and you'll find a broken-hearted man. Maybe then you'll understand. I'm not crazy, but I'm out of her mind. A broken-hearted man. Maybe then you'll understand. I'm not crazy, but I'm out of her mind. Thank you.
We're back now with Hank Ruff. And Hank, thank you so much for being here and I guess for performing.
Thanks for having me in the band. It was fun. It was real fun.
So what have you been up to recently?
It's been hectic and it was busy. So playing a bunch of shows all over the Midwest. You know, in September, we played 15 shows in the month of September. So I was having to drink a lot of honey to try to not lose my voice that month. And then like last week we played in Ohio on Wednesday, played back here at a big fraternity party on Thursday, and then played in Friday at Wabash College in Crawfordsville. So we're staying busy and I'm writing a lot of songs. I was in Nashville about 2 weeks ago finishing up what's gonna be the next single I'm gonna put out. And yeah, it's just busy between songwriting, playing shows, dealing with the business side of things. It's been fun.
Well, we'll get to new music releases a little bit later, but I know that in April you released your EP, Hellbender. And what's your favorite song on it?
Actually, it's the one, luckily we played it tonight. It's the slow, I'm Not Crazy But I'm Out of Her Mind is probably my favorite one on the EP, because my dad wrote that song about 30 years ago, 25 years ago maybe, and you know, I always loved that song, a cry in your beer, sad country song. And those are my favorites, and I kind of took his original version of it and made it my own, changed up the melody a little bit, changed up the chords a little bit, and you know, made it my own, but still, you know, his song, so it just kind of has a deeper meaning to me that, you know, I'm hopefully carrying on my dad's songs and songwriting, so
absolutely. I like
that. But the fourth song on that EP is a recording from middle school that I wrote. Most people don't realize it's me because my voice is a whole octave higher, and I wrote that song trying to get a girl back in middle school, and I had the recording, and I was like, why not throw it on as the last song of the EP there, so maybe that's the close second right there.
Amazing. Well, can you kind of walk us through your songwriting process? Like, what goes through your mind when you're sitting there writing a song?
Yeah. The process can vary in so many different circumstances. You know, sometimes I'm in the car and I think of like a line, something hits me, or I'll see a billboard or something. I'm like, that, and that line hits me, and then I start thinking of melodies and things that might, you know, work, you know, well with it. Other times, I just sit down with a melody I have and no ideas for a song or theme or any lyrics specifically. And I try to, you know, fit lyrics into a melody that I've kind of come up with. And then the other times, my dad, he's great with writing good lyrics. And so he'll have ideas in certain, you know, choruses of a song, and then I'll just take it and run with it. So the process varies all the time.
But
yeah.
So I guess that's what's going through your mind when you're writing songs. But what's going through your mind when you're performing?
When I'm performing my original songs or just any performing?
Just anything when you're in front of an audience.
Yeah. Well, so to answer the first part, when I said performing my original songs, I'm really trying to, you know, convey like the feelings I had and what I was feeling when I was writing it. And especially on like the heartbreak songs, like I would kind of want that feeling of emotion to come through to the audience when I'm playing them. But then, you know, when we're doing a fun cover song, a big, you know, well-known cover, I'm putting it all out there, bringing the energy, trying to let the crowd feed off what I'm giving to them. Jumping up and down, testing my vertical all the time in my boots. And I guess I'm just focused on bringing as much energy as I can bring so that hopefully the crowd feeds off that.
And I'm sure the adrenaline rush is crazy when you're up there too.
It's hard to, until it happened really, until these like, especially these Bluebird shows, once they really started, you know, taking off and filling up, then it was like, wow, like that's what it feels like. And, you know, in a club that size, you know, I think you almost feel the energy and the adrenaline even more than when you're in a stadium and you're further away from people, probably. I can't speak fully for that, I guess. Hopefully, eventually I will. But something about, I hear artists talk about all the time how they love playing the clubs over the big venues, because you just, that adrenaline you get is just, yeah, it's like nothing else when you hear them singing. Especially now that you know, some of my own songs now, when we play them here at the Bluebird, people know them, and that's a cooler feeling than I've, you know, ever had of playing a cover song for people.
And speaking of, you said, like, your hopes one day, big stadium. What are your future hopes right now within, I guess, the next year or a couple years?
Yeah, I mean, obviously, the goal obviously would be, if we're really ambitious, playing stadiums.
Yeah,
in here.
But, right?
And, you know, realistically, you know, I just want to keep growing in any, I never want to feel like we're going on the downward slope. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you know, I'm recording new songs, writing new songs, I'm in Nashville all the time now, I'm meeting with hopefully the right people. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if as long as I feel like things are going up, then I know I'll feel good where we are in a year. So I think that's kind of where I'm at, as long as I'm feeling like we're making progress.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And I guess final question, I know you mentioned that you were finishing up a new single, so when can we expect new music from you?
So I didn't want to, it's almost done. I think we're going to have it done. I'm going down to Nashville next week and we're going to have it fully finished. but I didn't want to compete with Christmas music. I was like, we're not putting it out in December. Yeah. Mariah Carey is going to take the crown there every time. So we're going to wait. It's going to be out in mid-January. We're going to put out that single, and that's going to be the first song out since Hellbender in April, as you said. So I'm excited. You know, Hellbender ended up charting on, for a day, it charted number one on the iTunes all-genre chart. We beat out Encanto for a day, so it's going to be hard to live up to the last marker, but I'm excited to have another song out soon.
Well, we can't wait to hear it.
Yes, lots of exciting things for sure.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. And that's What's Up This Week.
Be sure to follow us on social media. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter at IUSTV News.
For What's Up Weekly, I'm Anna Black.
And I'm Callie Lichter. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.